Susan Spratt, Duke endocrinologist. Today I'm talking to pharmacist Patrick Gregory and dietitian Ileana Vink to answer some of your questions about medicines for diabetes. One class is called a GLP-1. So Patrick, what is a GLP-1?
Thanks, Susan. It's a great question. So GLP-1, or glucagon-like peptide 1, is a hormone that helps lower your blood sugar. And GLP-1 receptor agonists are medications that act like your body's own GLP-1. Some GLP-1 medicines are used every day. Others are taken once a week. Most are injections, but some are pills.
So Patrick, how do these GLP-1 receptor agonists work to help manage your diabetes?
Yeah, so this is a question I get a lot from patients, and there are four ways that GLP-1s can help manage your diabetes. So number one, they help your body release insulin. Number two, they help keep your liver from releasing extra sugar when your body doesn't need it. Number three, they help slow down how quickly you digest food in your belly, which helps you feel fuller for longer. And number four, they send signals to your brain that you are full, so you eat less and hopefully lose weight. Taking a GLP-1 medicine helps lower your blood sugar and your hemoglobin A1C. It helps reduce the risk of problems like heart attack and stroke if you are already at high risk of those. And then it also helps protect your kidneys. A few examples of GLP-1 medicines include things like liraglutide, or brand name Victoza, dulaglutide, or brand name Trulicity, and then also semaglutide, which has a pill form called Rybelsus and also an injectable form called Ozempic.
Ileana, I think it's important for patients to understand how GLP-1s might affect their eating. What can you tell them about that?
Yes, your food choices make a big difference in how you feel when you start taking a GLP-1 medication. So when you start taking a GLP-1 medicine, you may notice side effects like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, or constipation. To prevent these side effects, try eating smaller portions than you are used to. So for example, if you usually have a sandwich and a side of chips for lunch, instead try having half a sandwich. Then wait an hour or two to see how you feel. You may feel better eating smaller amounts of food more often, or you may find that you feel satisfied with a smaller portion and don't need to eat more. Don't lie down right after you eat. This can make you uncomfortable. Be careful with high fat foods. That includes fried foods, fatty meats like hamburgers and hot dogs, or chicken with the skin on, or high fat dairy foods like ice cream or cheese. High fat foods can be harder to digest when you start taking a GLP-1 medication. Your provider might start you on a low dose of a GLP-1 medicine, then increase your dose gradually. This can help with the side effects. Keep checking your blood sugar when you start taking a GLP-1 medicine. The GLP medicine on its own shouldn't cause low blood sugar, but if you take it together with insulin or another medicine that lowers blood sugar like glipizide, you can have low blood sugars.
If patients are considering starting a GLP-1 medication, you should know reasons not to take them. And that includes people with a history of thyroid cancer, pancreatitis, or gallbladder problems. They should avoid taking these medications. People who have stomach emptying problems or other problems with their digestion may have a hard time with GLP-1 medications. Ileana, anything else you think people should know?
One more thing to think about. To take a GLP-1 medicine, that's an injection, you need to inject it into the fat layer that's just under your skin. You can do that in your abdomen, staying two fingers away from your belly button, or outer thighs, hips, upper buttocks, lower back, and backs of arms. If you also take insulin, inject your GLP-1 in a different spot than you inject your insulin. Keep your GLP-1 medicine in the refrigerator and away from the light. Talk to your provider if you have any more questions about this type of medicine.